So, this video assumes that you already have XFLR5 installed. The first step is to go to Module, Direct Foil Design. Next, create two airfoil shapes by right-clicking anywhere in the open space, then going to Foil, NACA Foils. Enter 2412 in this box, then click OK, then save the airfoil. Repeat this step and now enter 0010. Save that airfoil. Next, go to Module, Wing and Plane Design. Click on the plane shape here that labeled 3D View. Then go to Plane, define a new plane. And near the top of the screen, you will see a spot for a plane name. This can be used for naming the plane. We usually use anywhere numbered system from V1 to V10, updating as we go. Or add a modifier to describe the orientation of the ailerons and foils. A follow-up description can be placed in this description box. It's also good for copying a list of sizing details for the plane. Go to Main Wing Define. Then click in both foil boxes to select your airfoil type. Go with the 2412 for the wings shape. You can edit the length of the wings by going to the second Y box and editing the number. You can edit the thickness of the wings by going to both chord boxes and changing the numbers. The first number controls the thickness of the wings near the root of the plane, the section closer to the fuselage, and the second number controls the thickness at the tip. And the offset controls how much the tip is moved backwards. So at a high number, it's really far back, and at zero, it lines up perfectly straight. And so for now, we will go to 0.02, so that the sum of these two numbers is this number. You can also add a dihedral angle, which will angle the wings upwards, and a negative one will angle them downwards. Save the wing changes. Go to the elevator and then select the 0010 airfoil. The Y for the tail is usually about half of what the wings is, so we'll go with 0.35. And the chord is usually a pretty similar number. And no offset. For the fin, we go with the same chord as the elevator for the root chord, and we always make the tip chord slightly smaller and make sure that they align by having the sum of these two numbers be this one. The exact numbers you do for your first test aren't that important. And also again, the NACA 0010 for the fin shape. To make the fin align with the elevator properly, you will change this number here to match up with this one. You can also change the colors of each of the outline shapes by going here and saving the edits so that they are brighter and very easily visible. Save all changes. Next, go to current, right click anywhere on the screen, go current plane, define inertia. And this window is where you can add masses for the plane. For now, we can just create a center of gravity mass. The planes are usually around 3 kilograms, and you want to place it around the middle of the wings, that's around 0.12, just to approximate. Save, and if you check the masses box, you can see where it's located. You can also create motor, landing gear, and wings masses if you want to get more detailed. If you're going to create a dynamic stability analysis, then you will need to create masses that have a positive and negative y value. They can't just be zero. And you want to make sure it remains symmetrical, so you negative 0.4 and wing right. Save that. Then go to analysis, define an analysis. We always go with the fixed speed analysis type. And you usually set a speed between 30 and 45 meters per second. And for this one, we will use 41 meters per second. Then go to this analysis tab, check horseshoe vortex, and make sure that viscous is unchecked, and save. After that, you can rename your analysis to something like cruise, since this is the conditions we will be comparing it to. Save that. And then make sure sequence is checked and set start and end angles to negative 20 and 20 degrees with a increment of 1 degree, and then analyze. Next, go to the polar view, which looks like a sideways parabola. Click on that and you'll be able to see the results of your analysis. The force of Z graph describes how much lift force is generated. The coefficient of drag shows how much drag the plane is producing relative to its area and velocity. And the coefficient of lift is describing how efficient it is at producing lift. The coefficient of moment describes how the plane wants to change its pitch in this direction. You can see it indicated by this moment arrow. Basically, how the plane wants to change its angle like this. It's important to know the slope of this coefficient of moment graph. So you can enter the y value as 0.018. And then divide that by its x-intercept, which is around 1.12 degrees. So that gives a slope of negative 0.016, and we usually want this slope to be in the range of negative 0.5 to negative 1.5 for a good balance between stability and maneuverability. If you don't see these graphs, you can go to graphs, four graphs, make sure that four appear, and then right click, go to current graph, define graph settings, and then change the y-axis and x-axis settings to match these. The x-axis is always alpha, and the y-axes are force of Z, coefficient of drag, CD, CM, and CL. So that is all for today for a basic intro to using XFLR5 for DBF. Thank you and have a good day.